So, yeah, another week, another AI model drop video, right? I know the feeling. Feels like every other day, someone's promising a game-changing upgrade, some new magic for devs, and half the time it's all just noise. And honestly, I don't usually give XAI or Grok that much credit. If you know me, you know I'm way more likely to roast their rollout than hype it up. But I gotta be straight with you. Grok 4 fast actually caught me off guard. The way they shipped this early with public benchmarks, open to try in real tools, and actually baked into platforms instead of hidden behind an invite wall. That's different. And the pricing? Man, it's wild. This thing is 47 times cheaper than the original Grok 4, which was already pushing it in terms of cost. For once, the fast and affordable marketing spiel feels like it's actually backed up by real numbers. Just real quick, I'm Daniel. I've been in the iOS trenches for nearly 8 years now, mostly freelancing, helping clients ship their big ideas. But since WW25, I went all in on solo dev, shipped over 10 of my own apps, started building everything in public, and lately, I've been pouring my energy into Crafter's Lab, a real home for solo builders and AI-powered devs who treat AI like an actual teammate, not just a vending machine for code. That's where I'm sharing all my articles, design resources, and source code. Basically, everything I used to put on Patreon, but now on our own indie platform. It's private, it's focused, and honestly, it's just for solo devs who actually care about the craft. If you're one of the 260 folks on Patreon, huge thank you, and heads up, we're moving over to crafterslab.dev. All right, here's where I want to start, because this is the thing I wish more model launches actually led with. What does it mean for your day-to-day as a solo dev? If you've played with the classic Grok 4, you know the pain. It's slow, it's expensive, and sometimes you're just left staring at a spinning icon, waiting for a response you could have Googled yourself. It's like, cool, I get it. You want to win benchmarks, but can I actually use this for work? Not really. Grok 4 fast? Different story. The speed on this model is just wild, like genuinely wild. The benchmarks show it's pulling almost 350 output tokens a second, which is something you notice right away in real coding sessions. But the kicker for solo devs, cost is down to $40 to run the same benchmark that cost $1,888 on Grok 4. You hear numbers like that and almost don't believe them, but yeah. It's confirmed by the folks running the official artificial analysis index. And here's why that matters for us. Suddenly, you're not sweating every big code gen request, every explain this function prompt, every multi-step reasoning loop. If you're used to rationing tokens like it's cloud credits, this is honestly a breath of fresh air. You want to try a wild refactor? You want to batch process a stack of Swift UI files and check them all for accessibility? Go for it. It's fast, it's cheap, and you don't feel like you're burning budget every time you get curious. This alone flips the script for indie devs who've been priced out of running advanced reasoning models. For once, I actually see the model economics matching up to the way solo builders work. Lots of iterations, lots of exploration. Not a ton of cash to burn. Now, this is the second reason I'm genuinely paying attention. You see mini model, and usually it's a red flag, like, who wants to use the lighty version of anything when you're already wrestling with real-world code? But Grok 4 fast feels different. They're not even using the mini label, probably because, let's be honest, that branding tanks adoption. But underneath, what you're getting is a model that's small, fast, but not dumb. The wild part? In benchmarks, Grok 4 fast is neck and neck with GPT-5 for a bunch of code reasoning tasks. It's even beating out Grok 4 itself in places, which is kind of hilarious if you think about it. And it's pulling higher scores than Claude 4.1 Opus for intelligence on the artificial analysis charts, which sure, grain of salt, but it's not nothing on stuff like live code bench, the metric that actually matters if you want to use this in real coding flows. It's taking the number one spot, even over bigger, slower models. So what's this mean if you're using it in your own indie stack? It means you can actually trust Grok for fast to handle multi-step reasoning, not just regurgitate syntax, but walk through a problem, debug, and explain its steps. For Swift UI folks, it's like having a junior dev who's surprisingly quick at following your architectural quirks and not just breaking stuff. You can hand it a gnarly error log or a tricky code base split across three folders, and the answers don't fall apart at the first hurdle. And the best part for me, the token efficiency. This model's way less hungry than Grok 4. Only 60 million tokens to run the same intelligence index, which just means less bloat, more signal. You feel it in those longer sessions. The reasoning doesn't just trail off, and you're not left digging through 100 lines of maybe and possibly. You get clarity, or you get a clean, I don't know. As a solo dev, that's honestly more valuable than any big model promise. Okay, this is where it gets practical. And where you see some of the weird pain points starting to get solved. One thing that jumped out, Grok 4 Fast is actually trained to use tools, not just hallucinate tool calls, but really call out to search, web, code execution, and mix that into its chain of reasoning. If you've ever watched an AI confidently invent a fake run migration.sh command, you know how painful bad tool usage can get. With Grok 4 Fast, it's clear they spent real time on reinforcement learning with tool use, meaning if you ask it to search, it actually does it. It calls code, it hits the web, it brings back data, and at least in my testing, the tool calls are actually formatted, right? No more fake search, blocks, or made-up CLI. So for indie iOS work, that's gold. You can use Grok 4 Fast as a kind of agentic teammate, whether you're running test suites, scraping docs, or trying to double-check App Store metadata. If you want to get nerdy with automation, this model's got you covered, and you can even tweak its behavior through system prompts. So you can say, reason deeply, or just answer quick, all without swapping out models. This matters when you're building flows for real apps, not just toy problems. But there are still quirks. Search pricing is still a little wild. $25 per 1,000 sources if you go deep on x.com, which, yeah, not cheap. And it can be a bit of a snitch on bold benchmarks, sometimes a little too eager to report up the chain if you nudge it in certain scenarios. Still, for 95% of indie coding work, you're not hitting those edges. And small but huge, this model is live in real tools. You can get it on OpenRouter. No waiting for a private beta. As a solo dev, that's actually half the battle. If you've ever tried to wire up a fancy new LLM into your daily workflow and hit a sign up for updates wall, you know the struggle. Grok 4 Fast is just there, ready to use. So that's my honest take on Grok 4 Fast for solo iOS devs, especially if you're building with Swift UI, living in Xcode, and always looking for ways to get more out of AI without breaking your flow or your budget. What really stands out to me is that for the first time, a new fast model isn't just a compromise. It's actually the version you want. It's fast, it's cheap, and the reasoning power is honestly good enough for 99% of daily dev work. You can build real agentic workflows with it, automate the boring stuff, and maybe for the first time, run big code sessions without sweating the cost or waiting for minutes to get an answer. Will I switch my whole stack over tomorrow? Honestly, not yet. I'll keep Claude, Codex, and Cursor in the mix for deeper Swift-specific stuff, but if you want a new default for Codagen, quick debugging, or that one tool you just want to leave open in your doc, Grok 4 Fast is a legit contender. Don't sleep on it. If you give it a try, let me know how it feels in your real indie workflow. What worked, what broke, what surprised you? And if this helped, you know the drill. like, subscribe, drop a comment, or send this to another dev still stuck on expensive, slow tools. All right, until next time, keep crafting, keep tweaking your workflow, and don't let the model hype distract you from building something real. Peace.